This isn't always something that's easy to pull together. We've been talking with Nike for about 16 months now, trying to get the design process done. First, we took to them some ideas and some different concepts that we wanted to have included, and then they came back to us with how to incorporate all of that into the uniform, the jersey numbers, the stripe on the pant. And then from there, once we kind of green-lighted the project, we kind of have to get everything ordered, get the guys sized. Obviously, we had to do that all in secret. So that process took us a little bit of time. There's new jersey materials, new pants materials. That all changed on how it all fitted. And then just the ordering. We had to do all the ordering for cleats, socks, the uniforms back in October. So about 16 months ago, we started. Just kind of been cranking on it, getting it done, trying to get everything in since then.
So were you nervous along the way that this was going, somebody was going to leak it? And were you surprised a little bit that it wasn't leaked?
It was a very, very small group of individuals that knew about it right from the start. And a lot of it was really on me in communication with Nike. When I'm doing the ordering, I couldn't let anybody see it. I couldn't let any manager see it. So I'm trying to have secret conversations with Coach about what we were ordering and how we were doing it. Yeah, that was pretty tough. I was very surprised it didn't get out. James is like he always is, very hands-on, very detail-oriented and all that stuff. And so getting his direct feedback and the route he wants to go with something, that's always important. So he helped in a lot of the aspects, making sure he wants to make sure the team looks good, and all those aspects are important to him. So having his input was huge. We kind of looked back through our whole history. It started as just a throwback, what do we want to do? And then as we started to look at the different time frames in the history of Penn State football, we landed on a couple of things. Like, Nike kind of found the jersey numbers when they were doing some research, but we always knew there was a stripe on the pants, the number on the helmet, the sleeve trim. Those concepts were always there in the history. So we kind of, once we started doing the research, we decided, as it's called, generations of greatness. So versus throwing back to any one era, we kind of tried to incorporate a number of different timelines in there. We saw the design about 16 months ago, and the final product, I've kind of had the jersey design and the pant design underneath my desk for about 4 or 5 months now. Hadn't seen the socks or the cleats up until it was all put on the mannequin or put on Josh a couple weeks ago, and then it was pretty impressive how it looked. We've always been solid. We've always had that iconic uniform look, so we wanted to make sure we honored that through this design. So when Coach Franklin, mentioned the subtlety of it, I think we did a great job of making the little changes. They were very subtle, but they do honor the different eras of Penn State football. I guess for me, what I'm trying to get out of it is I'm trying to do something that's not only going to benefit the university, but it's going to benefit the student athletes. So if there's something that they're looking to do, or they want to go out there and be portrayed in a different uniform, if it makes them happy, my goal and everything I do as an equipment manager is towards the student athletes. I mean, that's what I'm here for. That's why I do this, is to help them grow and achieve their goals. So, when you look at doing a project like this, if it's going to benefit the student athletes, they're going to enjoy it, they're going to have fun with it, that's really important to me. I think we started looking at in the 50s, kind of where we drew the numbers from. The one of the design concepts and thoughts from Nike was the, I can't think of the bowl name now, it's slipping my mind, but 1959.
Liberty Bowl?
1959 Liberty Bowl was kind of where we had started and drawn on. Just that generation and that era is where we started, and then from there, we just kind of expanded it to try and take into account all the different generations.